Sup infected, how's it going? My name is Apocalypse Nick, and welcome back to another episode of Undertale. I'm really sorry for the times I've been gone. It's been 3 weeks since I've made a last video, and I'd like to personally apologize to all of you. And it's been a while since I've tweeted, letting you know my current status on this channel, which I again apologize for. My issue is no one's gonna come yet, but nobody came. Oh my god. My issue was that I've been busy with school, and the holidays were coming up. When Thanksgiving vacation came, I assumed that, that I was gonna be able to do stuff, and I was gonna be able to, help out with this channel a lot more. Or really just do stuff in general, which wasn't the case. And, I ended up losing track of time. I ended up losing track of, like, when to upload. It wasn't even just losing track. It was also of, hey, I need to get my homework done. I need to get work done. Because after work, I got homework to do. And, it was a very stressful situation. And YouTube is not my job. I'm not Markiplier. I'm not, PewDiePie, Jacksepticeye. Heck, I'm not a big YouTuber in general, as you can tell by my sub count or my view count. But, it's just a hobby I like to do. I like to entertain people. And I only film certain games, because in my case, with my computer and with my situation, some games in my case are unfilmable because they're too long and they take longer times to edit. But, my other issue, too, is that, I just didn't have a lot of time to get the stuff done that I wanted to. And it really did stink because, I didn't want to make it sound like I was making excuses. So when I would try to tweet a lot to you guys, it was like, hey, I hope everyone's having a great day and whatever. You know, just generic tweets and stuff. But, oh god, I forgot Blue Geese House. You can't listen to the music. Spiderweb. It's a flyer for everybody speaks on it. Nice. Do. Alright. But, like I was saying earlier, I didn't have a lot of time to get the videos out, so it took me a lot longer than usual, which honestly does stink. It doesn't seem like anyone's home. Yeah, because it's Undyne's house, the person I'm trying to kill. It does suck, and I don't like using that as an excuse, Oh, I'm carrying too much. I remember I'd actually want to go back here. Dog residue. Well, I can sell that to Temmie, I forgot. I don't think I need anything from her. She doesn't sell any good items. That's only for really, that's only for the, other things. Oh, wait, I can't go back, I think. In case you guys don't know what I'm doing, I was trying to get the, there's a special item I could get to fight Undyne. It probably would make it easier than the ballerina shoes. But yeah, like I said, I've been busy a lot with school, work, and then the holidays. You know, Thanksgiving, I've been spending time with family and friends. And now Christmas is coming up, and I'm going to be doing that. I just decided to get a video out. And like I said, this isn't my job, so it's not like I can easily film a video and just, like, work on that. And just, like, you know, work on that and make that something. Oh my god. Yeah, so like I said, it's not like it... This music's just disturbing. But like I said, yeah, it's not that easy for me to just, like... You know, just get a video out. But anyway, we're here now, and that's all that matters. I think I would just, like... Right now, I think I've just been talking about how I couldn't get a video out. That shouldn't be an issue, because we're here. I wouldn't buy your chizzy garbage at knife point. Wahaha, so you came here, what a treat. Bye. Don't expect a discount. Wow. Wait, cloudy glasses. Oh. Kinda. Ooh. I should buy that. Don't you have enough? I don't. I have a... Oh, in terms of inventory. Shays. Crap. Good riddance. Yeah, okay, buddy. You too. Use the box. Yes. What? No, use the box. What are you doing? What are you doing? Use the box. And then, buy the glasses. No. Torrent. Oh, this is where I buy it. Good riddance. I hate you too. That we were friends, man. After I murdered all your friends. Alright, you equip the glasses. What? How many things can I equip? Stat. Oh, that's my armor. Oh, because I don't have the tutu. Oh. Where do you find the tutu? Oh, because I had the man in the bandana. Okay. Well, I'm just going to use the book now. Torn notebook. From, I think that's the Soul Perseverance. I've been watching a lot of Undertale comic dubs lately, my friends. Also, in case you guys didn't know, I've got my own Apocalyptic Nick t-shirt. You can't see it that well, but I got my own Apocalyptic Nick t-shirt, which is what I wear every video now. I don't know if I showed you guys earlier. I think I did. I'm not sure. I can't remember. But, hopefully this stuff is going to help me defeat Undyne a lot easier. I don't know. Take a space food bar from the cooler. Yes, you got the astronaut food. Hopefully that's going to help me kill her. I got a lot of health items. I got the glasses. That should help me. Maybe the book's going to help me kill her. I don't know. We're going to find out. Relatively soon. If nobody came, how can I get stopped by an enemy? But yeah, this game itself, when I've been looking at it and playing it a lot, it's relatively dark. And it's relatively creepy. And I'm not really, like, happy about that. I'm not saying it's bad. I mean, it's a great game. I'm not saying I hate it. Like, oh, I don't like the fact that it's dark. The game Undertale seems like a go-happy game. And then, like, it's like a different game altogether the moment you do genocide. I mean, all the story ties in and everything, but it just seems so different when you get into it. And it's just like, holy crap, I didn't expect this to be in it. Also, off topic, but onto the Undertale genre. There's this awesome YouTuber by the name of... Oh, I hope I don't butcher your name. So if you're watching this, I'm sorry. Camila Cuevas. She's a Spanish YouTuber from what I know. And she does animation. And she's really, really good. She might not say she's good, but I know she's been like, oh, you know, my drawings aren't that good. I know she's done that sometimes, but no, her drawings are awesome. And her animation is pretty good. She's on the series called Glitch Tale, which I'm sure a lot of you have watched and a lot of you know about. I think it's awesome, and you know, I just feel like you guys watch it. I saw her entire season one. I'm watching season two now. Episode two came out recently, and oh my god, is it amazing! It was like so like oh my god, I loved it. It was awesome. Okay, Monster Kid's gonna stop me right now, and I can't get past. Yo, what's up? We already know the dialogue here, I think. I believe so, we do. What's up, dude? Yo, I told me to stay away from you. She said you hurt a lot of people. But, yo, that's not true, right? Yo, why won't you... Oh, so I didn't save the... Oh, I think if you close down the game, it goes back to this. I know if you die by Undyne, he'll be like, what, look behind me? And I was like, and what's with that weird expression? What, you mean this expression? That weird, like, frisk expression? The frisk emoji, everybody? Oh, man. I mean, I would do character voices right now, but I'm chewing gum. This awesome gum. It's like, oh, I can't show the gum. I might get a copyright strike. I don't know if you can or not get a copyright strike by showing a label, but I think you can. I won't show it. It's good gum, though. It's Mentos gum. I'm not showing the gum, though. What would Undyne do? She'd fight. But I don't know if No Arms Kid over here is going to kill me. You know, hey, No Arms Kid, try to fight me if you can. I'll kick your butt and beat you. I'm going to do the old-fashioned cop. I'll throw the book at him. Literally, that's what we're going to do. We're going to throw the book at him. You'd better stop right where you are, because if you want to hurt anyone else, you're going to have to go through me. Oh, get through me first. I'm sorry. And oh, shut up. Act, Monster Kid, check. Last kid, 2 attack, 2 defense, looks like free XP. He doesn't attack at all. That's the set. Oh. What? Oh, no. Oh, no. I forgot to equip the notebook. Oh, this is gonna suck. Crap. We're dead, guys. I didn't equip the notebook. No! Alright. Also, I'm having trouble with my microphone settings again. And I don't mess with them. I swear to God, I don't. You probably noticed that from the beginning of when I started filming. I pre-recorded like 5 episodes of this already. Just to see if the audio would work, and it didn't. So I had to delete each every episode and start over. So I don't know if my audio is any better or any worse. It sounds like garbage at 10% volume, but it sounds a little better when you get to 50% volume. I don't know why. So I don't know if my audio is very screechy right now. It's not my microphone, I swear. Okay, I might need to get a new microphone too. It is a little outdated, but still. I hope not. I love my Yeti. I'm gonna have to get a new one soon. Like, goddammit. I think it's when I start screeching in my voice is when it sucks, but I hate it because it sounds so choppy and disgusting. I'm gonna do my best to fix that. Yeah. Alright, let's just fight her and get this crap over with. Oh my god. This might. We already know this dialogue, guys, okay? I promise. You're not missing anything. It's stupid. Can you leave, Monster Kid? I need to kill her. I need to get my XP. We want to fight, you know, the awesome people. Can you shut up? Oh, la 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 la. Shut up! I need to kill you, Undyne.
Oh my god! Aw, you're so annoying. You're not dying anytime sooner.
Oh, you. Oh, great, yay! But no, she's not gonna die. She's gonna do her monologue. Sorry, that's just. Oh my god, this is taking forever. Yes, congrats, you're not gonna die, I get it. I do not hate Undyne, but jeez, she's like obnoxious a little bit. Well, only in the genocide mode is she obnoxious. She's fine any other game. Also, I'm gonna get a new Logitech camera. The one I have, the downside is it only records at 30 FPS. There's one that records at 60 FPS at 1080p, so yeah, I'm gonna get that instead. Maybe that might make my videos a little better, and it won't be laggy as crap. You know, so yeah, we're gonna fight her now. And now the awesome music. Dun, dun, dun. Okay, the awesome music. Any minute now, I wanna see hear that awesome music. You're gonna have to try a little harder than that. Okay. Undyne the Undyne. Yeah, I don't wanna check. Alright, I really wish we, oh god. Sorry if I don't talk here, I always gotta focus. I can't talk and focus at the same time. Good to see I didn't lose my spunk. I haven't played this part in forever. Oh god, yep, I lost my spunk. I lost it. I lost my spunk. Hey, it doesn't take out as much health as it does when the bandana comes. Oh god. Alright, so that makes sense. You gotta get hit a couple times. You gotta break a few eggs to make an omelet. That's how you're gonna kill her. You know, you gotta, like, dodge a little bit of her. Oh, god. Oh. Yeah, I'm a little rusty from last time I played. If not, I'm worse. I don't think we're gonna kill her. I honestly don't. Oh, god. Dear lord. Oh, you are harder to kill. Oh. Sweet. Oh, sweet. Kill yourself. Oh, no. Oh. Okay. Item. Snowman piece. Aw, I thought I was gonna recover all my health, whatever. Boom, 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 boom. Alright, those yellow arrows always get me, but it's fine, because we're almost gonna... I swear to God, if I kill her with the ballerina shoes, I'm gonna go absolutely ballistic. And to be honest, we've done a lot better than we have here on most tries. Oh my God, we're doing a lot better than we did last time. Hey, we might kill her on our first try. We don't know. Oh God. Okay, guys, we got this. Snowman piece. Oh, cool. 45 HP. Oh God. Oh God. Jesus. If she keeps doing the yellow arrows, we're gonna not make it. Okay. We got the hang of it. We got the hang of it, guys. Oh my God. Okay. Oh. She's actually slowing down. We're doing so much better than we did last time. Oh crap. Okay. Oh! Dang it. It's funny how the slow arrows kill you. I'm not even mad. I haven't raged yet. Because that's fine. We're going to throw the book at her. We need to equip the book. We're going to throw a papyrus. I keep forgetting I named him Papyru. I didn't take that part seriously. Alright. We need to equip the book, though. Uh-oh. No, not that. I didn't mean to call to her. What? Oh, I'm gonna have to go all the way back, and I don't wanna. That's what happens when you don't check things. Alright, maybe I put it in the box by mistake. If not, I'm gonna have to buy it from him. Oh my God. Alright guys, I'm gonna cut the video here. I'll be right back in a minute. Bye. And we're back, guys. We're gonna fight them. I equipped the book. I forgot to get the book. I accidentally put it in the box. I'm sure some of you saw that and you're like, yo, Nick, you left it in the box, right? But I'm sure if there's a live stream, you all would be like screaming at me like, yo, you left it back in, back, you know, back there. You friggin' idiot. So we're gonna grab the book. Oh, that was the book. It just spins and you whip. Is that how Perseverance actually fighted? She just used... I'm assuming Perseverance is a woman, by the way. She just, like, hit people with the book. Oh my God, that's bad. Also, I'm sorry if my text box is, like, in the way of the text. I always forget to, like, move it before game. I probably could put it on the left-hand side. I'm gonna do that in the next video. I'm sorry. I'm doing this to you guys. Alright. Oh my God. That does absolutely not a lot of damage. Boom. Oh my God. Actually, I'm starting to think the ballerina shoes were a better idea. I'm starting to think the ballerina shoes were way better. Eh, whatever. Alright. Oh God. Alright, the glasses give me more defense, actually. I think they do, at least. I don't remember taking this much damage, in the, oh God. In the, oh my God. I remember taking this much damage in the, last playthrough. I could be wrong, though. Oh my God. Okay. I'm doing my best here to stay alive. We might not kill her this try. It's gonna take us a little bit. Ah, dude. The notebook actually seems like utter garbage. It doesn't seem like it's doing a lot of, It doesn't seem like it's doing a lot of damage. I feel like the other one was... Oh, God. Alright. Snowman piece. Boom. No problem. It's no big deal. We might win this. We might not. Oh, okay. Oh. Okay, that happens. Okay. No! I accidentally went in item again. Oh, my God. That might have just... I went in the item again. I just used up one of our, I just used up, wow, and we didn't get hit. Oh my god, that doesn't happen. Okay. Alright. Oh, I was so stressed there. Alright. Oh god! Alright. Oh! Oh, my health was maxed out, huh? Ugh! I keep dying by the regular arrows! We're getting hit by them. I'm sorry for like not talking during this. I'm just trying to focus because we want to kill her so badly. Oh crap. Oh. Oh. I probably should have healed up there. I probably made a huge grave mistake. Shit, 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 shit. Holy God! It's all good. It's all good. I'm okay with this. I got this. We'll be back in a minute. How many people think we're actually gonna kill her? I don't. But we'll find out in a minute. Oh, ma'am. It's all in the hands. It's all in the wrist. It's all in the, it's all in the determination we've got. This notebook is actually garbage. I'm actually doing worse. I hate that in games where you're trying to focus and then like you do worse. And the game's like, oh wait, you want to do better? Like, oh, I'm sorry, it's not that simple, buddy. Alright, how do you dodge half of her attacks? I just feel like it's impossible. I just feel like it's unfair. I don't mind her doing a lot of damage if I do a lot of damage. Is that okay? Because I want her to die. I need to get to the next level. It's not fair, and I need to kill you. I'm sorry, Undyne. It's nothing personal, but you need to die for the greater good. You need to die for my genocidal habits. You need to die by the notebook. I'm going to say I gave this fish the nastiest paper cut of your life. It wasn't there. Here's how you died. By a notebook. I'm going to ruin your legacy. Oh, God. Okay. I always get messed up there. I don't think we're ever going to figure that part out. Or I'm not, at least. You guys probably have. You're going to be like, Nick, you stupid idiot. It was so simple. You've ruined it. Okay. So, we remember. Snowman piece. Right here. It's maxed out our health. We might got this in the bag. And by in the bag, I mean we fucked ourselves completely. So, like, it's really cool. Just don't let them close up too much. Don't get hit. And then you go in a fight, grab that notebook, and just, like, hit her with it. And then she gets, like, a massive paper cut. She gets really happy, though, when you hit her with it, though. Oh, God. Oh. Okay. Well, that's fine. So then you grab the notebook and hit her with it one more time. And look, it's like 1260. So you grab that, that's up, that, that's down, that, that's up, that, that's down. It's like a pattern. You know there's patterns. You hit her with the notebook, hit her one more time, like, I'm dying, you suck. 633, no, that's not, that, I take that, that's like, I totally think that's fair. No, I don't. So we're gonna go up, that, like that. So great, so you grab that, grab the notebook, kill yourself, boom, instant is 1449, and that's really slow here. What you do to go? No hit. No eye, because we're the best. Now we're gonna grab this. Oh, boom. Instant kill. 1199. And it's not instant kill. It's the best I can. It's the best I can do as of right now. Just run. Oh, God. Alright. Grab a snowman piece. Max out your health. That's what you max that out. And it's gonna do this again, but it's gonna go a little faster. You grab that, grab the notebook, and then just, like, hit her with it. 980. Oh my god! I'm so stressed out right now. Oh! Alright. You guys don't know how stressed I am right now. Oh! Oh, 22, that's not enough. Fuck. Oh, I'm so scared. Okay, I'm getting rid of the monster candy, guys. It's okay. We did better. We did better. Oh, we were so close. Once you get down to the monster candy, you're done. I don't want to run back and get the friggin' astronaut food. Like, the monster candy's like a last resort. Like, it only does, like, 10 HP. We need to get rid of... Oh, dude, no. I'm gonna buy all the MTT steaks. And I fight Sans. I don't care what that did. Oh. Oh, how it does 200 damage there. But not for her. Oh, dude. We got this, though. We got this, and we's gonna kill her. I don't care how long we've been playing for, we're gonna kill this. The glasses help a lot, actually. Way better than the bandana. Probably better than the ballerina tutu. Boom. 1071. I don't care. I can take that. Up, 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 right, down, left. Okay. Her first attacks get strong, and as she gets weaker... As she gets weaker, her attacks start to slow down just a little bit. I'm sorry, I just... Okay. Alright. That might have just ruined our chances. That's if I can dodge the rest of the attacks. That's one thing I don't like about her. Some of her attacks are undodgeable. It's upsetting, actually. That's not... I did actually worse on the most easy attacks in the world. And I just attacked her. I should have taken health. Alright, so... We'll just do a monster candy for her beginning attacks. Oh, oh! I got it! Only use a monster candy for a beginning attacks, because they're not that... Alright. We gotta use a snowman piece here, or we were gonna kill ourselves, dude. Alright. Alright. Just stay near the edges. Alright. 900? Are you kidding me? No, 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 no. Alright. Oh! 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 No! Oh. It's getting real up in here. Oh, crap. No! Alright. That might have messed me up. Okay. We got this! I'm sweating so hard right now. Oh, okay. Okay. Boom! Sorry, I'm leaning in like that. Just, oh god. No. Oh! I'm actually angry. I'm so angry right now. We almost had him. I'm just doing worse. It's not fair. Stay determined. I don't know, man. It's too hard. I don't know if I wanna! I mean, I'd rage, but I think I'll lose like 10 years of my lifespan, you know? I can't play for too long. Because my brain cells are dying and I got things to do after this. Just, I don't care. No, like, it makes a difference, okay? Okay, I just want to kill. After this fight, guys, I'm ending the episode and we'll continue after that. You know why? I don't have all the time in the world and I don't have all the brain cells in the world. Okay? I'm not willing to. Like, after this fight, I'm going to be exhausted. She's the second hardest enemy in the game. She's the most second hardest enemy in the game, you know? Like, she's the second hardest enemy in the game, and I'm not willing to fight her over and over and over again. Okay. I almost lost touch of my keyboard there. I just did... Oh, crap. I just did shit for an attack. Okay. I have no idea how I survived that, but I'm gonna take it. Boom. Okay. 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 We're doing better. Okay. I'm so stressed. You don't even know. Oh my god. God damn it. Whew. Oh god. We've got this. Oh. Ah! Please don't. Oh. I need this. Okay, hold on a sec. Oh, okay. Okay. Oh God. Oh, I think we did it! We did it! Woo! Take that! Oh, I'm so sorry for everybody's ears. I'm so sorry because my audio's not that good. So I might have blown out all your ears. I'm so sorry. Damn it. So even that power, it wasn't enough. Nope. If you think I'm gonna give up on hope, you're wrong. Oh my God. Cause I've got my friends behind me. I'm sure. Alphys told me that she would watch me fight you. Oh crap. I forgot she has that computer on me. And if anything went wrong, she would evacuate everyone. By now, she's called Asgore and told him to absorb the six human souls. Oh, she's melting, Jesus. And with that power, this world will live on. Oh, crap. Crap. Okay, since we killed her, I'm gonna save back there. I don't know if there's a save point over there. I forget. Oh, shit. Alright, it disappeared. There better be a save point over there. Otherwise, I'm gonna be furious. Please, don't do this to me. I need a save point. Oh, good. There's one right there. Thank God. Oh, yeah, because she, determination. Alright, you know what, guys? We have a little more time for more. I lied. I just didn't think we did. Just cause, oh my God, I was so stressed. I didn't think we were gonna win. I'm sorry, I didn't speak. I was just trying to focus. I was like so stressed. I'm like, oh dude, we're not gonna make this. Like, oh, we're done. Like, we ain't making this. Like, I was sweating. I was so stressed. I was like, oh God. So welcome to Hotland. Oh no, it doesn't work. All right. Oh my God. All right. So, we're gonna, like, I don't know. See, it's a water cooler. Take a cup of water? Yeah, sure. Take a cup of water. Get rid of the water? Yeah. You pour the water on the ground next to the water cooler. Okay. Save right here. 40 left, huh? Alright, so I gotta clear out this entire area. Hey, there's the riverboat man. Tra-la-la, I'm the river man, or I'm the river woman. It doesn't really matter. I love to ride in my boat. Would you like to join me? Oh, I think the river, perhaps another time, or perhaps not, it doesn't really matter. So I guess they don't attack me. Oh cool, I'm going to Alphys' lab. Yep, I knew she was watching me still. It's me, Papyru. Gotta add that Papyru in there, you know what I'm saying? Messing with her. Oh, there he is. Hey, Metaton. Oh, there you are. Yeah, we're gonna give you that voice again. You ugly little creature, you've made quite a name for yourself. Such infamy, I'm impressed. Oh yes, if you're looking for Alpha, she's not here. While you were so busy doing your thing, she was running around evacuating people to safety. Now they're in a place where you'll never get to them. Deciding not to fight you, my, she really is the only smart one, isn't she? Oh, how sassy. Yeah, he knows he's gonna die. You know you're gonna die. You're just itching to get your hands on me, aren't you? Well, too bad. This world needs stars more than it needs corpses. Toodles! Oh, so, like, considering Frisk is incapable of running, I'm not gonna... Oh, can I not? It's a bathroom scent, yeah, so, he's not gonna... go up there. Oh, cool. Okay, so nothing really has really changed around here. Oh, wait, maybe. It's a prom poster from Metaton Superior on the flap. It says, thank you for making my dreams. Oh. Okay, never mind. No. It's just, it hasn't changed. Okay. So that doesn't make a difference. So. Oh. Alright, so I think I... Can I cut through here? Oh. It's a force field. That's actually unique. I've never seen such a... Okay, so you're forced to come over here no matter what. So, yeah. I'll just kill the rest of the 40 and get new weapons and whatever. So, yep. I forgot how to get the tutu. I remember Kindness. He has the apron and the frying pan. I didn't get those. I got the apron. Wow, Hotland sounds different because of the genocide mode. I actually like this way better. This sounds way cool. Time to die. Ah, nice. Ah, I'm an asshole. I feel bad because some of my friends really like this game. And they're like, don't do genocide, please. And I'm like, but I need to. For you guys, I want to see how it goes on the channel. And everyone's like, don't do it, don't do it. Like, it ruins the game so much. I'm like, oh, come on, please. I'm like, well, then again, I don't care if they don't want me to, because I still do it anyway. It's just the issue, it's like, oh, come on. Oh, Sunder playing. I love it. I love how it's got that little Sundere face. Human! Oh, crap. Oh, God. Oh. Boom, there you go. Time to die. But I never got to, declare my love for me. I don't know. You're a Sundere. I don't know. I'm sorry. You're not a Sundere. You're a Sunder plane. There's a big difference there. Oh. All the traps are cut off. I guess Metaton ain't gonna do his TV show thing for me. I think he's gonna wait for me and just, like, fight me right then and there. He's gonna be like, oh, yeah, dude, you're gonna die. Like, it's a switch. Press it. Yeah, sure. The lasers will react. Oh, yeah. Press it. Yeah. I need to, deactivate those. We don't want those on. We don't want those messing up what we have. So I want to make as much Oh, you can't play this game. Shoot the okay. I kind of do miss some of the puzzles in the game, like a little bit. That was the sad thing about it. I mean, I guess now that you're doing genocide, you can't really do that. Oh, I'm gonna fight these two. You're here. So that means... you're here. So that means Undyne. She's... like... Undyne. Will avenge you. Alright, so... I forget which brother likes who. I think it's the bunny ear brother. Royal Guard 1, Royal Guard 2. Whatever. I'm assuming you like your brother. Oh, God. 0-1, you! Oh, God. Oh. Yeah, Undyne was a pretty hard fight. You two are sadly pathetic. I easily killed both of you. Wow. your love increased. Can you imagine, like, just murdering one of your loved ones and, like, oh yeah, your loved increased. I don't think it did. Oh, the cooking show. It's bringing back so many memories. Can I? It's just glued to the. It's glued to the table. Oh. 36 left. I gotta kill all of them in Hotland. Aw, oh, dude. I love the game's graphics. Everyone, like, says the graphics in this game are bad. I don't say so. I mean, I'm not saying, oh, if we had better graphics, the game would be so much better. I don't really think so. That's just me. But, yeah, I don't know. I don't know. I think the game's fine the way it is, in my honest-to-God opinion. I don't think it needs to be changed at all. I don't think the graphics need to be better in order for this game to succeed. I mean, it's a great game already. We're going to level left 4-3. I don't know. I wonder, No, she evacuated everywhere. I was about to say, I was like, wait a minute, can I see, like, Grilby's daughter or whatever? But I don't think you can. Looks like some sort of powerful bracelet. Wait, it's just a croissant. Oh, it's a spider donut. It looks more rubbery than usual. Spider bake sale. All proceeds go to real spiders. Oh, so one of my friends made me think of this theory, and it might start a theory with you guys. It goes, so Muffet makes, or her spiders, actually, she's a coordinator, but her spiders make these donuts and croissants and all that. It says, spider bake sale made for spiders of spiders by spiders. So it's made for the spiders to eat, but it's made of other spiders, and it's made by spiders that make this. So, she's force-feeding her own kind to other spiders. They're cannibals, which is actually kind of freaking crazy. I actually kind of like this music. Aw, I wish I could get the genocide version of the Hotland. It's really cool. Oh, it's not that bad, actually. I kind of like it. Alright, that wasn't that hard. But yeah, I mean, like... Oh, dude, I went the wrong way. But, yeah, she's a cannibal when you think about it. She's eating stuff made for spiders, of spiders, by spiders. Like, that's so gross. Like, oh my god. Oh, did I just go the wrong way? Oh! Oh, okay. Oh, crap. Oh, I moved! Oh, wait, no, I didn't. I was stuck in the corner. I guess holding down the arrow key doesn't count. If you think lasers are gonna stop me, what is this? You stop to smell the flowers. Ah! I get it. Stop and smell the flowers. Wake up, smell the... I went the wrong way. Wow, this is agitating. Alright, please tell me this is the right way. Oh yeah, I hope this is. This is it. Guys, we might actually be able to get like 30 fights in. So, I don't know how I'll label this episode. I might label, like, I'll think of an episode name as I play. So we might label this episode Killing Fishies, Spiders, and Robots. Wow, so much was accomplished in one day. Well, that's too long a title. I think I'm gonna get caught in your shitty web. Ooh, did you hear what they said? They said a human wearing a striped shirt will come through. I don't know, I'm making them have British accents. I heard they hate spiders. I heard they love to stomp on them. I actually hate spiders, but I'm too terrified to stomp on them. Like, oh, spiders? Dude, like, you see, if I ever saw a spider, I'd burn this house down. Like, God, no, I'm joking. Done. I heard they like to tear their legs up. I wouldn't even do that to a spider. It would just bite my hand, and the venom would, like, make it implode. Oh, dude. There's too much of a web. I heard. You heard what? That they have some awful taste. What a shame. A human comes through and they aren't even fit to be eaten. Oh well, rotten ingredients can always be discarded. I wonder if I don't, like, if I don't immediately attack her, will she become any harder? But I don't want to. Just because, Ew, no. Oh my god, if I hit spare, that would have ruined everything. It's gonna be one shot. How much you wanna bet? I knew it. It was gonna be one shot. The only enemies that won't be one shot is probably gonna be Sans and obviously Undyne. I know of the Sans fight because my friends told me. I'm sorry, spoilers. Spire just looked at her. She's like, I'm done. I'm gone. I'm out of here. Oh, a rose for her. Oh, a flower for her. I kind of feel bad now. Wow. I feel like a jerk. Wow, okay. Guess that, we're literally killing people so much today. Oh my god. Now the music makes me feel worse. Oh, the puzzle was working, now it's not. Alright. Oh yeah, so we gotta stay in Hotland. I wanna kill the rest of the minor enemies. I wanna get as much XP as possible. Cause I think the more XP, the more health you get, and all that jazz, and I just wanna, like, so when I fight Metaton, all the high level characters, we have a chance of what we're doing. After I kill all the minor enemies here, we're gonna stop. It's because well, frankly, I don't want to do too much in one episode. Like, that'd be bad. 35 left. All right, so that's how much we gotta do. So I got quite some work to do. So it's gonna be a while before I can fully and truly kill one of the enemies. And yeah. So okay, let's just go. We're on right floor 2. Let's go to right floor. No, we're on right floor 1. So let's go to right floor 3. Maybe that's it. I do love the soundtrack, though. Oh, it's different. Huh. Let's go to right floor 2, then. Went to the wrong one. I just want to get rid of the rest of the enemies. Like, oh my god. Right floor 2. Let's go to Sans' little hot dog station. You know what I'm saying? I've never fought Sans, ever. I just know of it. Like, oh, really? So I'm gonna have to go around. Let's go to left floor too. Alright. That stinks so much because now I'm gonna like have to do all that other stuff. Oh, so if you guys like, I'm sure some of you have. Oh, really? How am I supposed to get rid of the other enemies? Oh, do I have to go back to the beginning? Oh, that's gonna be so bad if I have to go back to the beginning. Go through all those puzzles to get. Dude, no. I need to do a full-on genocide run. I need to kill the rest of the enemies. Like, no. Oh! Oh. 35. Oh, shit. Okay. So the force field doesn't work when you get. I will stick in one area. I'll just farm in one location until, like, there's none left. So, yeah. I'll just. The only thing I gotta say about the genocide run, though, is, like, it's so much better. Just cause, I guess, like, Alphys isn't here to really annoy you. Like, she's not here to be, like, oh, good, yeah, we'll just farm here. Alright. Boom, you're dead. Alright. I'm just gonna farm here then. Why the hell not? Like, it's so much easier that way. I feel bad though, because like we're just killing everything. I don't know, because it's like, what I'm trying to say is, what would you do in a situation like this? Would you honestly kill the monsters? And I know what you're gonna say in the comments below. No, Nick, I wouldn't do that. Like, I love them too. They're adorable. They're so cute. Which, again, I can relate to in terms of game physics. But if I fell in a dungeon, or a cave or whatever, filled with nothing but monsters, they're not going to look like they look like in the game. They're not going to look like a cute animated cartoon of a goat or a skeleton. they're gonna look like actual monsters. I have a poster up there of what they would all look like if they were real. And to be honest, I would just like, I'd kill them. I'd be like, oh my god, this thing's trying to kill me. I need to kill it before it kills me. You know, like, that's something you gotta look into. And, this is something I've always considered. I'm like, okay, it's either me or the monster. Like, it wants to kill me for its freedom, but I don't want to die. So, it's like, what do you want to do? And, I mean, I probably wouldn't, like, if I was in this game, I would try to spare. I mean, if it was real life, I would do my best to spare. I mean, I'd do my best, like, not to spare them. I didn't mean not to spare. I'd do my best to spare them, but in reality, if a monster's trying to kill you, I think all of us would try to kill it. And I mean, it's just, I don't know what to really say or what to, I don't know really what to say or do in a situation like this. I love the Cinder plane crashes and just doesn't turn to dust. Like, oh my god, is that morbid? Also, I killed, like, Undyne and her royal guards, and I still haven't leveled up yet. I don't remember the last time I leveled up. Would it tell me, hey, you've leveled up? I don't know what's worse. Killing all the monsters until nothing's there? Or killing, like, running into a monster in Genocide, right? I think it's worse, because this music's right now awesome. And the moment I kill a monster, it's just gonna be, like, it's gonna be, like, the slowed-down version of Flowey's music. And yeah, actually, guys, in case you didn't know, that's, I thought I was stuck. I would have been so mad. That music, when it says nobody came, and then, like, nobody, and then you have all that creepy music, that's Flowey's music slowed down, I think, 100%. And it's just so creepy, because it's like, oh my god, it's like, oh no, dying of fire. It's like, yeah, that's creepy. Oh god. Oh god. You need to die. Burn, baby, burn, yeah? I don't care. I got so much health, it's unreal. I can... Boom, boom. And you're probably... You're almost... I'm a level 13, huh? Buddy, I forget what level you become. Level 13, and I'm already, Damn. I'm brutal. Oh my god, this is just bad. I just want to clear each entire level until there's nothing left. Because it wouldn't be right if I just left this room unfinished and we were doing a genocide run. I'm sure some of you people are calling me a monster right now. I would so play Skillet's themed, feel like a monster as I'm playing this, but I can't because of copyright strike. You know, I just love that song so much. I feel like a monster. That song is amazing. And those of you guys who really like the Undertale, game, if you want to buy merchandise, go to fangamer.com, that's fangamer.com, no, there's no / apocalyptic Nick, sadly, I don't have my name into any sites yet, so you can't get a coupon, but, Toby Fox has used, Fangamer, you know, to market his stuff. Of course, you can go on Amazon and eBay and buy stuff there, but if you want legal, I mean, I'm not saying it's illegal to buy that other stuff, but Toby Fox said any other things that's not in Fangamer is being sold outside of Fangamer. He goes, it's strictly forbidden. I don't know how, like, that's getting away with it. I think he just doesn't care. I don't know, or just doesn't know about it. I have no clue. But if you want, like, games merch he's approved, or merch like he actually loves himself and has bought, go to fangamer.com. There's a lot of cool stuff. I bought the Megalovania t-shirt there, and it's a lot more like better, a lot more well made. It's a lot more stuff. There's new stuff every time. Like this game's been out for about a year now, and he's still making merch to this day. Or not, he's not making the merch. People are making the merch and giving him the idea, and he says, yeah, sure, we'll market that. But people are still making merch for this game today. This game's gonna live on, guys. It is. Like, it's not a bad game. It's a really good game. And I think it's gonna live on for quite a while. Kinda like Skyrim. That game was out since 2011. And they added some DLCs. And they added a Skyrim Special Edition. And the game's still being talked about today. And still played today. And that's what I think this game is. I honestly think this is one of the best games I've played. Definitely in the top 10 of games, along with Skyrim and a couple other games. Skyrim will always be my favorite game, because I've never played something exactly like this. And yeah, you could probably justify, what about Earthbound? But no, I've never played Earthbound. So I can't really say I've done stuff similar to this. Boom. Idiot. I wish it said Baka. I wonder, actually, is there a comic dub where Alphys is friends with the Sunder playing? Because that would make so much sense. That's horrible. It just keeps crashing. Now, I'm also wondering if the Sunder plane has people inside of it. That just sounded wrong. Anyway, we'll just get off of that topic. Yeah, there's a lot of things that could be still done with this. Not with the game, I mean, like, with the fan base. I know we have comic dubs. Yeah, there's a lot of things that could be done. Like, I have a few ideas myself, though. Some things I want to keep secret because I want to do them and not have someone else steal them. But I'm so willing to give ideas right now for some of you who want to do comic dubs. Like, if you guys are actually, like, no offense, I've seen a lot of comic dubs which are just terrible and they're really bad. But A for effort, I guess. And I'm not saying my videos are good. My videos are bad as well. But I do my best to make it good. I just feel like some of these comic dubs, they don't even seem like they've tried. Yeah, like, I feel like there's some comic dubs that could be done. Like, maybe Alphys being friends with the Sunder plane is one of them. I would do that, but, like, I can't draw as good as people would like. So I can't draw awesome Alphys with a Sunder plane. Like, that's not my skill. Now, I do art not for a living, but for school and stuff. Because I'm in graphics. I'm in a technical school. But, I've just never gotten to that level of expertise and skill yet. So it's a little hard. And it's a little tricky. Oh, I probably should have killed Vulcan first. The fact that I got what I just got was amazing. It doesn't even matter. Alright, when am I gonna level up is the question. Shh, you know? I probably do level up and it just doesn't tell me. But yeah, guys, like, I've always loved Undertale. I still love it to this day. I used to be a big fan. I'll tell you some of my backstory a little bit into my life before playing this game. I used to be heavy into anime, which I still am. I just haven't watched a lot of it lately because I've been busy with a lot of things. My friends would make fun of me for it constantly. And I got called your generic anime fan lover names, which I don't want to say here because I don't want to give you guys ideas. But, I eventually found Undertale and got into that, and now I am basically, you know, made fun of for that now. But I think it's a good game, and, you know, I think if you guys like it, that's awesome, you know? I mean, it's a great game, it's good to be loved, and Toby Fox knew what he was doing. From what I heard, actually, about Toby Fox, I heard he's from Massachusetts, which is cool. Just like Casey Lee Williams, she's from Massachusetts. And she does the music for Rooster Teeth, which I find awesome. That's amazing, actually. Like, she does the opening for Ruby, and it's just awesome how she does it. It's cool. There's so many cool people from Massachusetts. Now, the reason I keep talking about Massachusetts is I'm from Massachusetts, guys. Yes, and I really do. I really do love my state. I just thought there was not a lot of cool things here, but we got a lot of cool people here. I would love to meet Toby Fox in person, though. That's awesome. Of course, the guy's a lot older than I am. He's in his 20s. I'm only 17, but hopefully that won't discourage. No, but still. I'm just going to kind of take this off a little. Like, we'll have one ear out so I can actually hear myself speak, because it's weird. It's so weird, like, having yourself speak or whatever. Now, I know I'm walking in a circle right now. I'm just doing that to get to farm. When nobody comes and we've farmed enough, we're gonna end the video. I'm just here talking at this point, farming. I don't know. Hey, you know what, guys? How about this? When I'm done farming, I will also kill Metaton, because that's not fair for you guys to hear me talk about random bullcrap and then just, like, me end the video. Like, you'd be so mad. not much has happened. I swear to God, I think we've killed Undyne within less than an hour. I think we've only been playing for an hour. We've accomplished so much within this hour. So, like, I can play for a little bit. But no, I am not fighting Sans within this video. I'd like to, honestly. Like, don't get me wrong. That's so crossing my mind. What it says, it's not that I like you, stupid idiot Baka. Alright, wow. I never got to bone your dad. Alright, so, basically what I'm trying to say is, I don't know, I actually might fight Sans in this video, maybe, but you damn well know we're not gonna kill him. He's one of the hardest fights in the game. The main reason I somewhat don't want to fight him in this is I don't want to expose too much to the game in one video, and plus, like, when I kill too many enemies in one video, especially in a game like this, I don't know what to put as a thumbnail. I don't know what to call it at the time, because when you kill, like, when I kill Papyrus and Toriel in the same video, my brother, known as Awesome Ninja, or Awesome Gaming, just Awesome Ninja, he posted down in the comments below my one of my videos. He says, "Hey, you should have labeled it this, and it was a great name." And I'm like, "God damn it, I should have." But I didn't know what to call it at the time, so I said, "Goodbye, Toriel." I should have named it The Twisted Fate of Papyrus and Toriel or something like that. And I didn't do that. And I actually regret it to this day. Of course, I can go back and just change the video, but I changed the video, I also got to change the thumbnail, and that's kind of a waste of time because I put all that time and effort in making the thumbnail and the video. So that's why I won't change it. That's why I'm like, no, I'm just going to leave it the way it is. Even though I kind of don't want to do that. Okay. But yeah, for this video, I don't know what to name it, and it's one of the issues. Of course, you guys, that won't matter to you. Because by the time you watch this, it'll be named and edited and all of that. So, like, it's not like you can, like, comment right now and help me. Though I'm sure some of you would do that. Oh, God. Alright. Alright. We can die right now. I'm gonna kill you. Leave. 100 XP. Oh, I'm level 14. See, it doesn't tell you if you level up. That's an issue. One of my friends, actually, when I, fought... He managed to glitch the game, I think. I don't know how he did it. When he played, he was, like, level 20 when already fighting, like, Undyne. And I was like, oh, I hate you so much. I'd love to be level 20. I don't know if you can be the level 100 in this game. I don't know. Maybe you gotta... The only way to accomplish such a thing, I think you have to farm so much in the ruins before you get past a certain door. I think once you get past that certain door, it just sets how many enemies are in the room with you. I don't know. Oh, 19 left. Okay, so we're almost done. But I don't know, really. I think it's better to kill minor enemies and clear out a ton of rooms in the genocide mode, because the more health you have, the better. Especially with Sans, or, you know, a Sans or somebody, because, like, I think something more like that, you need as much health as possible. Because that guy, he does regular damage, and then he does poison damage. I don't know if Sans himself does one attack. I know a little bit about his fight due to the comic dubs, and due to my friends telling me a little bit and showing me a little bit about it. So I kind of what I'm in for, which I do feel bad because I feel like I've kind of cheated myself out of an awesome event. But to be honest, if it's a genocide run, you kind of knew you were killing everybody. And I do mean everybody. Except Alphys, though. I knew she wouldn't be that stupid to fight you. Wow, that was just one hit kill. So, like I said, I don't know if Sans really does one attack and one defense. I mean, I know he probably has one defense. I think. I don't know. Considering you can one-shot everybody in this game. Well, the bosses, not the minor characters, which is honestly weird. But it's a little weird. I don't know. Like, let's just say he did one bone attack at you. Only one. One bone hit you. Would you only lose 1% of health? Because I know he does, like, 500 bones at you at once, and you're going to hit, like, at least maybe, like, 50 of those, which is going to take out a huge gaping bar of your health. On top of that, it does poison damage. That what makes him such an asshole. Like, he does, like, one piece of, like, health is taken away from you, and on top of that, poison damage. Which doesn't make sense, because how are bones poison? Like, maybe there's a backstory to that. I don't know. You know? I comment a lot on Undertale Amino, which is a great app to play. I comment a lot on that, on, like, stuff from Glitch Tale, from Camellia Cuevas, or, like, you know, this game in general. And I post a lot of cool stuff that I've gotten and that I've, you know, received. And Guys, if you want to check out Undertale Amino, I think it's only for iOS. I don't know about Android or Windows 10 phones, so don't quote me. But it's a really great app. And, you know, it's just like, you know, you can just talk nothing about Undertale. Now, if some of you aren't Undertale fans, of course, I don't know why you'd be watching this if you're not an Undertale fan. But if some of you aren't Undertale fans, or if some of you are not truly heartful Undertale fans, like your soul is attached to this, no pun intended, like you really do love Undertale. If you're not that into the game, there is just called Amino, the app, where you can have like everything under the sun. Like, now Amino the app is created by the fan base, is created by normal people who love a certain thing, and like, oh, I'm gonna create this own little app based on that, on the thing I like, and other people can join it. That's basically what it is. I'm not going to do that. I don't have the time to be a moderator or an enforcer or whatever to make sure everyone sticks by the rules. But like Undertale Amino itself is created by Amino, I think the company. I don't know if Amino is a company. I'm assuming it might be. But the Amino app was created by the Amino, the company. And then the apps within Amino app, some of them are by the original company. And then I think some of them are just fan-based people like you and me. So like if I want to create an own app, like, I don't know, like, Logitech webcams, the app, I could, but no. It's just like you can literally create whatever you want. I mean, for all I know, I think you can create like, I don't know, like whatever comes to your mind you can think of. I don't think you can do anything like bad though. Like you can't create porn sites on there. Thank God, because there are children that go on those apps, so no one would want that. But you can create anything else that isn't adult content on it, really, which is really good. So yeah, so there's something to look forward to. Like, if you have an interest in Kingdom Hearts, it's there. Not everything is there, though, too. Like, I mean, there's this huge fan base. Like, Ruby is there. You know, Ruby Amino is there and stuff like that. But if you look for something obscure, like, for me, I looked up, I think it was, like, and this was more of a test, really. I was not going to join this if this was the case, but Courage the Cowardly Dog. It wasn't there, so like not everything's on Amino the app. People have to create it, or you do. But like I said, there are some weird things on Amino the app though. I wish I've never found. There's one called Weirdo the app, Weirdo for Amino the app, and it's basically like if you're a weirdo, you can go on. I don't know what they mean by that. It's probably something dirty. I have no clue, but it just makes me very uncomfortable. All right. Alright, time to die. Hot enough for you? Alright. Time for you to die, my friend. 85. Burn, baby, burn. Disco Inferno. Okay. I hope we're getting enough levels. I don't know how much, how much XP? I forget, is it EXP that gives you the level or LV? I forget. Levels of I think it's both. I think you need an equal amount of both to level up. No. XP gets you your LV. XP levels up your LV, I'm sorry. LV is your level, but also stands for levels of violence. So it should be called LOV, love, which it is, but they call it LV for short. Funny. I find it funny how, because like, you look at these rocks, right? It's a generic RPG maker, and you get the black background right where I'm standing. So it's a generic RPG maker, except for the ramps and stuff, I don't know. But it's still a great game. So when you think about it, this is your generic RPG maker game, except it's made by a more professional program. Thank you, Toby, for this. But it's a generic RPG layout, but the story in the game is so good. Like, you're not going to find something like this in RPG Maker. You can't create, like, a Frisk. You gotta draw that out and implement it in the game. Which shouldn't be that hard to do. So, Temmie Chang, I think her name is. I know her name's Temmie. I don't know the last name is Chang. So, I'm sorry if I butchered your name. I do follow her on Twitter, but I haven't gone on Twitter for a while, as you guys can tell. And I haven't been keeping up with my followers. Not my followers, but the people I follow, I mean. So, I forget her name, but I know she did the artwork. The artwork for the characters. I don't know about the layout. I don't think so. I don't know. Yeah, don't quote me on it. Maybe she did. But she did really well to be good on this. You know, it's something she did. She implemented her own character. This game is really cool because I got to learn some things about it I didn't think I would ever get to know. Like some of the in-game stories. Like Papyrus's doodle was so weird. It didn't even look like a skeleton, but it was so weird. It was actually canon. It was like, oh my god, it's like, that's what he would have been, but they made him a skeleton. Then you saw, he released, if you want to see more stuff about Undertale the game, or like fangamer.com, like I talked about earlier, go on Toby Fox's Twitter, and then go on Undertale, Twitter. But, go on Toby Fox, because he talks more about him in his daily life, and more about Undertale. Undertale, on Twitter just talks about Fangamer and some things about the game, very few. But if you want to learn, like, Toby Fox released a couple things earlier on artwork on what would have been in the game, but he forgot to implement it. I don't think he's going to implement it now, just since he posted on Twitter, so I don't think he's gonna. You never know, though. Like, maybe he will. I don't know. If you want to watch, if you want to know, like, see what he sounds like or see what he does, like, I guess there was a live stream he was on. He did not show his face. He spoke in the live stream, but that's still fine. He did that stuff, talking about the game, talking about where he got the ideas and everything. You guys can listen to that. I listened to most of it. It's about a 2-hour long live stream from what I saw. So yeah. And no, I'm not gonna put any of what I said, like Fangamer and all that stuff. I'm not putting that in the link of the description below. You guys gotta find it. Cause I don't like putting other people's YouTube videos on my channel. It just makes me uncomfortable. Cause I don't want them to, like, assuming I'm stealing their shit or trying to, like, be a stalker and help them get a name. I don't know. I think too much into this stuff, but I'm trying to make my channel grow. So, yeah. But if you want to check out other YouTubers I watched a lot, then, yeah, you can check out my main, the homepage of my channel, because I've listed some YouTubers there you guys can watch, which is different because it's on the suggested bar. So yeah, I haven't seen some of the YouTubers I watch anymore, so I might take them down, because I don't watch them anymore. So yeah. YouTube has done bullshit systeming. When people don't watch a lot of my videos, it's gonna, like, just unsubscribe people from me. And I only have 11 subscribers, which, again, I'm happy I have 11. That's better than no subscribers. It makes me feel a little good about myself. But, it sucks, though. I'm sorry that I'm, like, leaning in this much. Like, I can't make my camera go any further down, but it sucks because, when I'm trying to make, I'm not saying, oh, I want to make a name for myself, because I'd probably be more stressed out than ever. Like, if I was, like, Markiplier famous, like, oh, Jesus Christ, that'd be sick. When I graduate, I would just do that for a job, like, all day and every day. But if I had that fame, like, right now, I would be so stressed, because I gotta keep up schoolwork. And I would have to keep up my actual job. And my people at my job really like me. So, you know, I don't want to quit that place because they're awesome. I mean, I do overwork myself a ton there, but I would never quit my job for YouTube. Like, I would do YouTube as a side hobby, as a job. But if I got, like, if I got movie deals and record labels and stuff like that, then yeah, I'll be like, oh, YouTube's gonna be my job now. Forget it, hands down. But, like, again, I'm doing this for a hobby. I'm not doing this to be famous. I'm not doing this to be like, oh, guys, check out me out. I'm so cool. I'm so awesome. I'm, like, the new Markiplier of the YouTube. No, I'm not doing that. I'm just doing it to make people laugh and be funny. I'm sorry if I'm not funny today. Like, I'm trying, but, like, you know, it's like, it comes naturally. It's just like, I try to talk. I try to do my best. The other thing most people ask me, like, my friends ask me, hey, why do you show your face in YouTube videos? Like, I don't get that. Like, what if I was a jerk and I post this all around your school? Would you be embarrassed? I'm like, yeah, I'd be a little embarrassed, but I don't care, because, again, people would know about my channel more. They would spread it to other people, and then these jerks who are making fun of me would send it to people who might like me. You know, that's cool. So I don't care. That's even better, in my opinion. Not saying I want that to happen, though. Because I'm not saying I want to be exposed in my own school, because that would make things a little difficult for me. But I'm not really scared to show what I feel or what I'm like. I mean, I am a little bit shy, but I'm not scared of people turning me into a meme or grabbing my face on a webcam and just making fun of me, because it's all in good humor, and it's a stupid internet joke that will not last that long. Like, the chances of this haunting me when I'm 30 are slim. You gotta do something really, really stupid on the internet to ever get made fun of. And someone like Markiplier, who's, like, giving motivational quotes every day, and he's showing his face on... Yeah, people make memes of him. People make sex art of him, unfortunately. But that doesn't stop for him being to who he is, because he just goes past the bullcrap and is like, okay, whatever. I'm just gonna keep doing what I'm doing. They can just keep doing what they're doing. Everyone's happy. And that's the way I am. It's like, hey, people want to do what they want to do with my face and, like, turn it into weird memes or whatever. I don't care. You know, because I stopped caring what other people think, you know? It's just like, don't care what other people think. Do what makes you happy. Be you. That's why I have anime in the background. You kind of can't tell, but next to my skull, that blue out frame is a Ruby watercolor poster I got from Rhode Island Comic Con. I didn't post that on my Twitter saying I was going to Rhode Island Comic Con because it was kind of almost last second. And then I went. I mean, it wasn't too last second because you can't buy your tickets last second. But by the time I went, I had to think of costume. I had to remake my costume a little bit. And I went to Sans, which is awesome. I met a lot of Undertale people there. I even got to see the Nostalgia Critic, which I posted on my Instagram. Hopefully you guys follow me there and you can see it. But yeah, I saw it on my Instagram. It was really cool. Though I didn't really get to speak to him too much. I just quick, hello, it's really great to meet you, and it was awesome. But I was too scared to really say much to him, you know, because it's like, I don't know what to say to a big YouTuber. Someone small like me and someone big like him, it's like, oh, I don't know what to say. But it was really cool meeting him. But yeah, I didn't really post much about it online. Mainly the issue of, I would always forget, I always seem to forget to film when I go to Comic-Cons. I filmed years, but bits and pieces from year, except I didn't film at all in, like, Boston Comic-Con. Not Boston, like, Rhode Island Comic-Con, I didn't film at all. I was too busy talking to the people I met at Boston Comic-Con, because there was a lot of vendors there I met, I really liked talking to them. But, it was just weird because, I was just doing a lot of shopping and meeting a lot of famous people. There's a lot of famous people. There was Walking Dead people. There was, like, you know, the children. It was weird. It was awesome. It was cool. But it was a little, you know. But yeah, it was a really interesting thing to go to. And, by the end of the day, I just was too tired. And, like, it was just me and my friend Cam, so. You know, you guys know of him. He was on this channel a while back, like 2 years ago, I think. No, his channel's only been on for 2 years, I think? I can't remember. He was on my channel a couple summers ago. That much is certain, but he's busy, so he can't help with the channel, sadly. I was gonna make him a, like, big part of the channel, and I do want him to be a big part of the channel, but, like, you know, when he's not busy. But also when I sit there, it's like, no, I'm not looking for help. This kind of channel is somewhat a singular thing. It's kind of like my channel, almost like my own personal channel, like Jacksepticeye's only Jacksepticeye's channel. He's really not putting anybody else in it, except maybe his, like, girlfriend every now and then. Or I don't even know if he does that, because I don't really watch his videos too much. But, you know, I know YouTubers do that. I might make a group channel, like Apocalyptic Studios or something like that. I don't know. I'll think of it soon. Who knows, you know? I just gotta get enough people who are willing to help me. I got a lot of friends who could help me, but they're busy with their life in school right now, and some of my friends are busy with their life with their, with their other friends, and so it's gonna take a while. So, yeah. And I'm gonna let you guys know, when I get out of school, I do have big plans in my life going on, so I'm not gonna be doing this forever. I'm not saying the channel's gonna be dead, but I do have, things I'd love to get done. Idiot. Yeah. But I'll talk to them about in the future, because I got ideas of what I'd like to do in my life. The question is if it's gonna actually happen, that could be different. The answer is I don't know. I have done a few things that may define my career in the future. I will talk about that later in the near future. That's everybody. But like I said, I'm gonna talk about that in the near future, because again, I don't know. I'm 17 right now, I'm still in high school. I don't know what's going to be in store for me in the next, couple of years. Not couple, but, like, you know what I'm saying. But back to this game. I know I'm ranting and raving, I'm just talking about blah, 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 blah. Oh, so as I was at Rhode Island Comic Con, you guys probably seen the awesome videos of, Markiplier, Yandere Simulator, Jacksepticeye, Undertale animation videos. Markiplier, Yandere Simulator animation videos, part 1 and 2, Jacksepticeye, Undertale animation videos, and the, Markiplier Undertale animation videos. No, those weren't animation yet, I'm sorry. But those two, you guys know them, and the one who goes, hugs for Bob, hugs for Toriel, and he's like choking Toriel. Well, the person who did that art style, I feel really bad. I forget her name. She was very awesome. She was there at Rhode Island, and I met her. I was like, wait, that art style looks familiar. And I went up to her. I was like, hey, did you ever do like an animation video for Markiplier and Jacksepticeye? She's like, yeah, I did. And I was like, oh my god, that's so cool. So we started talking for a little bit. I didn't want to take up too much of her time. She's like, she's a vendor, you know. So I get to let her do her thing. But I spoke to her a little bit. I was like, oh cool, you know, how do you know them? You know, and she's like, oh yeah, I know. I posted it on my channel. And Mark saw it, and he really loved it, and then contacted her, and she does. She makes animations for them every now and then, which is cool. So, yeah, it was really nice, awesome talking to her. It was amazing like that. You know what I'm saying? So it was a really awesome experience. I met a lot of famous people there. Those of you guys also played the Walking Dead game, the Telltale series. The Season 1 game, not the Season 2. I know the Season 3 is coming out. This is going to be awesome. I can't wait. Like, I haven't played Season 2. I've watched it from beginning to end, basically. I didn't play Season 2 because of the dog. I don't want to go through that and hear it yelping because I do like animals. And hearing a dog whine is like the most disturbing thing, in my opinion. That's why I won't play it. But in Season 1, the character Lily, which was the daughter of the father who constantly had heart attacks and hated you as Lee... I met the actor who played Lily, and oh my god, she was amazing. She was very, nice. She was very nice to talk to. And I asked her a couple questions about the game and everything. You know, it's cool. What happened to Lily's character though in the game? I don't know whether when she steals the car or if you leave her off the side of the road. I don't know if she's dead. Like I think everybody knows she's not dead, and that she's there. Oh my god, how many more enemies are there? Ah. Oh my god. That's bad. Alright, I'm gonna go back and heal up, because I'm at 27% health. I've noticed that when you kill more enemies, the more and more enemies you kill, the harder they're gonna appear. We've been playing for almost, an hour and 30 minutes. I don't know if we're going to get to kill Metaton. No, you know, we'll kill Metaton, but, like, we're not doing Sans. We're not doing Sans. We're not doing that. Like, that's too early. Way too early. No, happening. I guess the one thing I do hate about this reminds me a lot about Pokemon. It does. It really does. Reminds me a lot like Pokemon because he walks so slow. Frisk walks. Oh, 8 left? Yeah, then... Okay, we'll just count after that. 8 left. We should definitely be able to kill all of them after that. But like I said, the one thing I hate about this game is he walks so slow. Or, she. I don't know what Frisk is. You know, everyone doesn't know. Many people in the comic books make it like, make Frisk transgender. Well, not like both genders at once. Actually, some people have, if you know what I mean. They'll be like, oh, Frisk is just Frisk. It's neither girl or boy, you know. But if you, like, try to say, oh, Frisk is a girl, they'll be like, misgender Frisk one more time, I'll kill you. It's relatively funny. I've watched a lot of comic books. I still watch them now, and it's awesome. One thing I can't get over, I'm not saying it's, I mean, this is my personal opinion, I don't think it's bad as the Papyrus and Metaton ship. No, I don't ship at all. I'm not going to be like, oh, guys, like, we should put these two characters together and, like, drop it. No. You will never see me do that. When I see it, though, the closest thing I do to react to it is agree or disagree. And frankly, with that whole thing with the Papyrus and Metaton, I don't care. Maybe I missed something in this game, but I don't remember seeing anything of Papyrus and Metaton falling in love with each other. So I have no idea where the hell that crazy thing came from. You know, fangirls being fangirls, I guess. I don't know. But it was just funny. The only reason why I don't disagree with it, or just don't care, really, is because there were some interesting, funny-ass comic dubs of it. That's the main reason why I don't care too much. It's like, oh, cool. Well, as long as I get a laugh at some of these comic dubs, I don't care about the damn thing. When they get freaky and it starts getting disturbing is when I'm like, yup, get that shit out. Nope. Like, there was one where they have a child, and he's skeleton/ghost, and they just found this kid, like, not moving because the kid came out of his like body and he became a ghost because he wanted to see what it was like to go through walls. The funny thing though, he looks like an emo skeleton who loves spaghetti, and it's just like the funniest thing ever. You know, it's like, oh, it's an emo loving spaghetti monster. You know, that's why I just find it funny, and it's just like, that's why I don't take it too seriously. I know some of you guys get furious at that, which I can agree with. Like, it does get creepy. It does go too far in some cases. So we got 6 enemies left. After these 6 enemies, we can finally, like, just get on with our lives. Or, you know, like, oh my god, I just want to kill these enemies and get out of here. I hate how we have to farm in this location. I think this is the only location. I'm sure there's another location to farm at, but it's just like, I'm not willing to go anywhere else. Like, oh my god, it just sucks. So yeah. So, yep. After this, I don't know how long we can play for it, because I got a lot of things to get done, you know what I'm saying? Get her done. Get her done, you know what I'm saying? Get her done. So yeah. I'm running out of conversation already! Like, it's weird, right? Because when you do a video, you have so much to talk about. The scary thing in a video is, when you talk too much, you've run out of conversation to give. But I've seen a couple, I've seen a couple channels who just dedicate themselves on comic dubs, like any comic dub they can get their hands on, like Ladybug and Cat Muir. I forget what that is. The Fantastic Ladybug? I forget what it is. I forget the name of it. I'm sure I butchered the hell out of it. I'm sure you guys are gonna be pissed in a couple minutes. You're gonna comment down below like, Nick, you're an idiot. But I've seen comic dubs on that. Comic dubs on Disney. There's channels that just do nothing but comic dubs. Like my channel, just gaming and entertainment. Mostly gaming as of right now, because I don't have ideas for skits yet. But there's one channel. It's one thing to dedicate yourself to comic dubs, because at least if the Undertale comic dubs end, the channel can still continue on other hype trains. But there are just channels that dedicate themselves to nothing but comic dubs, Undertale comic dubs. Like, everything is Undertale comic dub. Like, the moment a person uploads a comic dub, they will use that. Like, there's even live streams, 24/7 live streams of Undertale comic dubs. Like, that's crazy. Like, I wouldn't watch an Undertale comic dub at 4 a.m. or 3 in the morning. Like, Jesus Christ, no, I'm going to bed. But, you know, people do, and that's awesome, though, because at least it's dedication to the fan base. It shows that Undertale ain't gonna die anytime soon. But the issue that I do get worried about, like, in 20 years, people are not gonna like... I'm not saying we're gonna hate Undertale. We're gonna remember it. It's gonna be a classic at that point. But when we see that, that channel's gonna die. And that's very sad, because... I'm not saying the channel's gonna be terminated. I'm just saying the channel's not gonna be as viewed as much as it is. Hey, maybe in 20 years you might want to watch a comic dub of Undertale. Yeah, you can go on those channels or those live streams if they're still up. But the issue is more channels will come out with newer content, and they're going to be like dominating. So like, if you have a channel that does strictly comic dubs and like you're doing other comic dubs other than Undertale, you're going to be flourishing more than the one that only does Undertale comic dubs, which is relatively a big issue to look at, because well, frankly, that means that the other ones are just going to dominate more. Why are there no monsters? Oh my god, no monsters are coming. Oh. Huh. I'm a little worried now. Oh crap. Okay, we're gonna have to go to a different area. I don't know any other area though that... Oh wow, there was a save up here. 6 left, I know. I know there's 6 left, and it won't... Oh, I'm so... No. God damn it, there's 6 left, and we haven't even... I hate that so much. There's 6 of them left, and they won't come out. But I don't get... I'm not saying I don't blame them. If I was gonna get, like, booked to death by a notebook, I don't think I'd come out anytime soon either. But the issue is I need to progress to the Metaton stage and kill them. I think, because I know, like, all the sprites come up. I know if this game was in real life, you would just kill the shopkeepers. Like, you wouldn't be like, oh, can I fight you if they said no, whatever. Like, I know damn well you would just kill them. If you were going actual genocide, like, you would just kill anything that's a monster. You know what I'm saying? Like, even Bossy, like, when he was outside in Snowden Town, you would just kill him right then and there. You wouldn't, like, let him walk with you and be an idiot. Like, if you're going genocide, you're killing everything that's a monster in your path. Maybe humans, God knows what. But if you're going genocide, you're going like ham. So, yeah. Jesus. Oh God. Boom, you're dead. 29, doesn't matter. Burn, baby, burn. So when you, if you kill both of them, who cares? Alright, I just want to get them out of the way. So we got 4 left. I'm gonna go absolutely insane if, I'm gonna go absolutely insane if we don't get the other two. I just need 2 more enemies and I'll be happy. Like, I don't care. Like, I don't care in the slightest. I just want to get this done. I just want to get these enemies out of the way. And I just want to do this, like, come on, man. So yeah. Like, oh my god. So, I've been watching, I've been trying to actually make my own merch for my channel. I know we're, like, really not that flourishing, or I'm not that flourishing. I don't even want to say I'm not that flourishing. I like to say we, because I don't think this is all me. Like, you guys make the channel, I don't. Like, I can be doing this shit for 20 years, and I'm not gonna be... Oh my god, the music just got creepier. Ooh, wait a minute. I think the more monsters I kill, the slower and creepier the music gets. Ooh, I don't like that. Ew. That's actually freaky. Well, like I said, you guys make the channel, I don't. And I'm never taking that for granted. Like I said, I'm doing it for fun and to make people happy, but at the same point, like, I want the channel to at least grow a little more, because I can't make people happy if people don't know who I am. That's the one thing I've took into account. But no, that does not mean I'm taking what I have right now for granted. I'm happy I even have this channel at all. I'm happy I have, like, the editing software and all that stuff at all. I'm happy I know how to edit and be a good YouTuber. I'm happy I do YouTube in general, because it's broken my shyness a lot. But, it's just one of those issues where it's like, it's like, how am I gonna help people? It's like, how am I gonna get to the world, you know? Markiplier and PewDiePie and Jacksepticeye, they were so young when this started. Even Smosh, they were so young when they started out and they gave out these original ideas. And PewDiePie started gaming when it wasn't a big thing, commentary gaming when it wasn't a big thing, and that's how he got big. And then, like, Smosh did skits so much that people love them. They're the only few skit people that they love. Rhett and Link do a lot of educational videos, but make them funny. So, Good Mythical Morning's really big. But it's like, what can I do that's original and what people will love? And that's the tricky part. Because you do anything similar to another channel, their fan base will kill you. And, you know, it's one of the things, like, I don't want to be a scarce, you know, a guy who does news reports. That's not who I am. That's not what I'm interested in. I don't want to do news and reporting on, you know, on just random things. Not YouTuber news, but news in general, because that's not who I am. I'm more of an entertainer and gamer, but the issue is, the gaming is easier because I can make it funny using my own voice and just play the games and talk to you guys. That's easier, but it's harder to get out there because everyone and their mother is gaming. And the big YouTubers always dominate that part of the stuff. But then in terms of thinking of original ideas, that's harder because some original ideas are so easy other people wouldn't think of it. Like me. So, trying to make a name for yourself is relatively hard. There's so many factors you gotta look into. And when I want to make skits, I can't do them by myself. I need my friends to do them. And I know that people like you guys would offer to help me. Like, oh, dude, I'd so help you. But it's like, it's harder to do it when you're not in the same room as somebody. You know what I'm saying? That's what I mean. So, like, and that's what I'm just saying. It's like, oh, dude, how can I do this? How can I think of something original? So it's one of the hardest things you gotta look into on YouTube. But like I said, guys, that doesn't mean I'm taking what I have for granted. I'm taking this, like, I love my hobby so much. I really do. And that's the one thing I guess. I am never taking this for granted, ever. I really do love it. I'm really sorry also if I'm, tired. I worked today, and I just got back at 3, and I was resting for, like, till 4. And I was, like, doing all the recordings probably till 4:30, which was stressing me out because none of my audio was working. It's probably not working as well now. There's probably some screeching in my voice, which is upsetting me because that's a brand new microphone. It's not that old, and it's not working. I even have a pop filter on it and a cap for it to reduce audio echo, And it's still not doing a good job, so I'm going to need to buy newer, you know, stuff. I wanted to get a Shure PG42 USB. But what I saw on Amazon, they're like $1,000, and that's just insane. I'm not spending that much on a microphone. Even if I was rich, I wouldn't spend that much on a microphone. Actually, maybe if I was rich, I would. But I'm not rich, so I'm not spending that much on the microphone. Heck, I'm not even going to save up to spend that much money on a microphone. Like, I'll pay maybe $500 or less for a mic, and it better be a damn good one. And that's a lie, saying, oh, if you buy a $200 mic, like, oh, it should be the best in the world. Or if you buy a $200 mic, it's not going to be better than a $300. Like, that's not true. Heck, I had a Blue Snowball, cost me $50. You're thinking, oh, $50 mic, that's going to sound terrible. It was the best sounding mic I've ever had. I just upgraded the Yeti because I had more podcast features and stuff like that on. That's why I got it. If I just wanted the mic, I would have gotten it. Like, there are some big YouTubers who only use a Snowball. That's all they use. I had two Snowballs. I had one, and I gave it to one friend. And I had another, and I gave it to another friend. I just didn't need them anymore, so. Though I am starting to regret it a little bit. I do wish I kind of had one of them back. But part of me knows I wouldn't. Like, I just wish I had one of them back. But then part of me knows I wouldn't use it. Oh, thank God. Okay. We're almost done, guys. Like, oh my God. Like, we're almost done. Boom. Oh my God. Oh my God. I'm still level 14. Oh my God. Oh sweet, I got 102. Okay, 168. I'm almost the next level. Oh my God. Two left. Oh my God, if I get one enemy right now, I'm gonna be like raging. I'm gonna be like so mad. I'm gonna be like, no, no. I just wanna get to the Metaton fight. And I feel bad because Metaton's fight, the Royal Guard fight, Toriel's fight, Papyrus' fight, I one-shotted all of them. The fight, there's only two fights in this game that are actually a bit of a challenge, and that's probably Undying the Undying, and obviously Sans. Like, they're the most hardest you will come across. Oh, in the Undertale store, I was thinking about this, because I think a lot when I go to work. As I was working, I think, hey, what if Asgore never killed any of the kids? And it was Sans. And that's why he's always making jokes to get rid of his depression. That's why he's always depressed. It's because he's killed the kids. But nobody knows about it. They all assume it was Asgore. Or maybe did Asgore kill a few of them, but I think Sans might have killed most of them. That's just my theory. I don't know. Oh, thank God. Oh my God. Oh my God, I'm so happy right now. I'm gonna put this back on. I swear to God, if they kill me here, and like, I have to find them again, I'm just gonna go so mad. I'm gonna like, rage so hard. I'm like, nope. Oh, sweet. Oh, cool, they're only doing the bomb thing. That's, like, so easy to dodge. Like, oh, done. Boom. Alright. Nobody came. Determining. Oh. Now it's gotten creepy. Actually, wait, I'm gonna go back to Alphys' entrance because I can just head back up and not go through all those puzzles again. We'll fight Metaton. I hate how when I was looking for enemies, almost none of them would spawn, but now that I'm not looking for enemies, that nobody came, things always gonna happen that eat the most. This sounds so creepy, right, guys? It is. But this is Flowey's theme. I think it's... No, not backwards. I don't think it's slowed down, but I think it's just Flowey's theme. In forwards, wow. I think it's Flowey's theme, just slowed down, like, 100 to 200%. Many people say it's Flowey's theme backwards, slowed down, but I think it's just Flowey's theme slowed down. Like, it's not backwards, but it's just so creepy. Oh god. That's just... ugh. I'm actually uncomfortable by this. Like, no joke. I'm uncomfortable by this music, because... one of my friends said, oh, you like Undertale? What would you do if, like, you were, like, asleep in your room? I just, like... had, like, didn't have a speaker, but I was able to play this music in your room in the middle of the night. I was like, I would freak out. Like, no, I would just burn my house down. Like, no. Like, no, I'm just, not literally, but I'd freak out, dude. Oh, no, I'm not going through that puzzle. Hell no. But, I would freak out because... oh, dude, like... dude, like... this music's just so good. It's like, because I do like Flowers and goes dun 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 dun. That's his flame. But then slow down to this. It's funny, right? Because it goes dun. It's like, you wouldn't even think that's his theme. It sounds nothing like his theme. It's just so creepy. You know what I hate, too? When you kill all the monsters, and you just go from room to room to room to room, and you're like, oh crap, I need to backtrack, and you've cleared all the, like, spaces. I hate this music, because, like, I'm going back into, like, five different rooms, and all you hear is this music. Dude, I'm not even joking, if the lights were turned off, I would not sleep at night. I would think something's, like, behind me. Like, this music's so disturbing. I hate it. I don't like it. It's, no. Just, no. Just no, 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 no. You can't justify it. Like, no, no, just no. But, like, nobody came and stuff. Okay, so steal. Stole 5G from the, wow. Read. Hey, this is Braddy. Hey, this is Caddy. If you're reading this, then, like, bad news, you mega evil weirdo. Alphys just came here, and she's taking us someplace super-duper safe. But first, we gotta use up these gel pens. Yeah, chill, Alphys. We don't wanna waste pens. And don't even think about stealing our stuff. Yeah, creep, leave our junk alone. Caddy, it's not junk, it's really valuable. Yeah, our garbage is really valuable. Oh my god, that's amazing. Anyway, it's anyway, in closing, you're a total loser. Yeah, loser. Yeah, ha ha. Signed, Braddy Caddy, heart. You know what I love? I'm taking your shit. Like, do you think I care? Boom. 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 Oh, can't run out of junk food. Alright, I'm just gonna drop the other items. Wait, I don't think you can. I think there's a box. Okay, what's this note? Hey, go up to the creepy alleyway on the right for some great deals. Oh, cool. I love it. That broke and it's now just pouring all over. Use the box? Yeah, let's use it. Oh, wait. I gotta switch my items. Use. You've equipped the cowboy hat. Oh, crap! You equipped the empty gun. Now, if it's empty, how can I use it? Yes. I probably should have, looked that out more. Like I said, though, I should have looked at the, the specs. The glasses are valuable. I know they make you live longer, but I believe, like, the glasses are better than the ballerina. And I'm assuming the apron might be better. No! The apron is as good as the glasses make you live longer. They take a lot of damage off. But from my understanding, the apron heals you in battle. I know where the apron is. Well, I did in the pacifist run. It's a lot harder to get at through the genocide run since all those force fields all over. And frankly, no, I'm not going to bother looking for it because that's too much of a pain. I don't think, be honest, though, you probably, I mean, it's funny though, right? I kept saying, oh, dude, I don't need the bandana's going to help me. I kept dying on Undyne's fight. I killed her within 3 tries on the with the glasses. I think the glasses helped a lot. So I think the equipment does matter a little bit in this game. I still would get that apron if I could. There probably is a way to get that apron. However, I just want to kill Metaton and just go into the Sans fight. If I need to find the apron to kill Sans, I will. I know that's friggin' redundant. I'm going to have to backtrack a fucking lot, but if I need to, I need to. Right now, I'm just not going to consider it because of the force fields, and I got to go through. Like, it's a puzzle on its own. I got to find a way around the force fields. That's too long. So I got the cowboy hat. That's all that matters. I have the mystery key, which opens up his friggin' Metaton's house. Which is kind of redundant, because, you know, we're doing Genocide Run. I want to backtrack all the way to the house. But, probably gonna have to. Cowboy hat. What's my my attack is 26. 17. My defense... Oh! My defense is 3/12? That cowboy hat better be good, because if I just got rid of the glasses... That's why I save my stuff instead of dropping it. Alright, let's go to the left. Nobody's here at MTT. Because the office evacuated everybody. You know what I find funny? I feel like Alphys would, like, try to evacuate Burger Pants, and he's like, I can't, my boss won't let me leave. Like, his boss is such a jerk. You know what I'm saying? Like, his boss is probably like, I bet he tried to evacuate with everybody, and then Burger Pants is like, no, Metaton's like, nah, dude, you gotta die. You gotta die. No answer. It's locked from the inside. Oh, so someone's hiding in there. No answer. It's locked from... No answer. But someone's in that room. They're just hiding. The elevator is in use. Oh, okay. Why do I always get the freaks? Poor Burger Pants. Are you gonna order or what? You don't have room. So do you want it or not? I wonder if I can talk to him. Why didn't he leave? Nothing else to evacuation. Evacuation? You're yanking my chain, little weirdo. So what if everyone else left work? So what if nobody's buying anything? Par for the course, little weirdo. Par for the course. Oh, instead of little buddy, it's a little weirdo. Metaton. Well, Metaton didn't tell me I had to work, I guess. But that's the thing! Sometimes he doesn't call me into work until he's halfway into my shift! Oh crap. If I don't play it safe, he's going to yell at me. Okay? Maybe yell is the wrong term. It's more like he has this CD album he plays that's entirely full of songs about how bad I am at my job. Oh, it's so bad! He doesn't tell you this in the pacifist! So sad. Why am I speaking? I mean, I'm not saying I don't want to speak to him. I want to know what he says in the chest mode. But, like, why would he just, like, walk to me, like, hey, what's up? Like, I just murdered thousands of monsters. I walk up to Burger Pants, like, hey, how's it going, man? Like, hey, what's up, Burger Pants? So, anyway, alone. Huh? Everyone else is dead? Does that mean I don't have to work today? God, that it were true, little weirdo. That it were true. Okay. I do find this music creepy but funny at the same time. Sorry, little weirdo. Threats won't work on me. I can't go to hell. I'm all out of vacation days! Oh my god! That's amazing, actually. Alright, dude. Alone again. Poor Burger Pants. But he's always been my favorite. I do love this game so much. Alright. Determination. We're just gonna kill him. Let's go for it. Hey! Why don't we just fight Sans? Screw it. Let's go. You know what? The actual, okay. Before I read this. I feel like, obviously, the genocide mode, besides, let's just say you knew what you were doing in the sands in an undone fight, and you didn't die as many times as I did. You would finish this way faster than you would the pacifist run, because it rules out so much other bullshit. Just saying, like, you get, the genocide run is so much easier. But, yeah. Alright, but I know my friends told me to not do the genocide run first. They said you'll screw up the game that way. I don't know what they meant, but they'll... I find out soon enough. My, so you finally arrived. No, okay. After our first meeting, I realized something ghastly. You're not just a threat to monsters, but humanity as well. I probably think I would kill humanity, knowing my character. Oh my, that's an issue, right? Because if I kill all the monsters, or most of the monsters, they have no place to live. You see, I can't be a star without an audience. And besides, there are some people I want to protect. Ha ha ha, eager as always, eh? But don't touch that dial. There's something you haven't accounted for. As any true fan would know, I was first created as a human eradication robot. I'm wondering how many monsters game did kill some of the humans. It was only after becoming a star that I was given more photogenic body. However, those original functions have never been fully removed. Come any closer and I'll be forced to show you the my true form. And I came closer. Fine then. Ready? It's showtime! Alright, time for you to die me. Damn. I forgot what he looked like, actually. Alright, no, that's not him. Metaton Neo blocks the way. He's got wings and like... No. We're just gonna... Oh, the empty gun killed him. And we just one-shotted him. Of course we did. Gah! Guess you don't want to join my fan club. Yeah, if you're deaf, man. That was so easy. Wow. Yeah, we're gonna fight Sans. Forget it. I thought it was gonna take longer. Oh, that's it? I don't see his body. Oh, he self-destructed. Jesus. That was almost pathetic, actually. Because it's like, hey, we're gonna kill... Okay. It was like, you couldn't even get attached to his character. You're like, okay. Well, I mean, you could in the passive. It's just not the genocide. I mean, I'm not saying you could anyway, because it is genocide. But it's just like, hey, okay, I'm gonna fight you. Took one hit kill. Like, done. You're dead. Boom. So. Yep. Elevator's taking a long time. I'd be so mad if this game was broken and froze right now. Oh, it isn't. Okay. If that game froze, you don't know how mad I would have been. I would have been like, oh, I hate this game. Bad game. Terrible game. Uninstall. I'm joking, okay? I'm just gonna keep walking. I don't know... If something... Actually, I'm gonna go to the elevator. Maybe something significant will happen. Who knows? Who knows? I doubt it, though. The elevator's in use. Okay, so I have to walk regardless. This is the city in the background. I know it's a decoration in-game, but I know this is the city in the background. Same, there was a city in the background of the ruins, but I didn't go in there to kill everybody. I'm sure you would if you were in the genocide run. And this city in the background, I'm sure you would go through here to murder everybody. Isn't this where Alpha gave everybody? Like, it's the underground. Where could she have hidden them? Someplace safe. Like, there is no place safe place. That's it? Okay, so... This music I do love. Like this, it's not music, it's just you just heard it. Like I like this this soundtrack. There was an Undertale animation where they did a couple compilations of the music in it, and he goes like, you see Papyrus, he goes, Wowie! My lessons are already working! You just decapitate him and killed him, and like this guy played as Sans, and he was really good Sans, and he goes like, no, he was like so mad. And as he was holding up the scarf of Papyrus, this soundtrack right here was playing, and it made it more ominous and sad. No joke, like, if someone died and then this song started playing, like, I would start crying because it's literally one noise stopping for a few seconds and starting again. Yeah, it's so ominous, and you could listen to it for almost ever. It's weird. Yes. I don't think we're gonna. What level am I? I'm already a 19? Oh, wow. There's a heart-shaped lock inside the box. Will you take it? Take it. Got the heart-shaped locket. I gotta go to item. Right where it belongs. Right. Oh. Oh, that doesn't even make sense. That's not, that felt off. That felt like that felt like something important. Right where it belongs. Is that my locket? Alright, now I'm gonna open up the other gift. Knife inside the box. Oh, it's not worn dagger. You got the real knife. Last time it said the worn dagger. Oh my god, it really did change. About time? Oh, right, because where are the knives? My bed. Oh my god. Oh my god. My drawing? Oh, it's in red text. What the hell? What? Our clothes. His bed. Asriel? Dusty toys? The box is empty. It's a golden flower. It's a golden flower. It's golden. Howdy, Papyru. I'm gonna say Pap, because it's gonna kill me. Howdy, Pap. You finally made it home. Shit. Remember when we used to play? Oh my god. But I remember Flowey saying, no, I'm not whatever you named the fallen human. He must be talking about someone else. Or am I that fallen human now that it's Jensen mode? It's weird. It doesn't make sense. Boy, today's gonna be just as fun. Took the key and put it in your phone's keychain. The entries are all the same. It's a trophy. Number one nose nuzzle champs 98. Jesus. Nothing useful. Still has that sweater. Oh my god. It's a king-sized bed. Macaroni art of a flower for king's dad. It's just a chair. It's me, Papyru. This is so ominous. I remember when I first woke up here in the garden. I was so scared. I thought you couldn't feel emotion, Flowey. I couldn't feel my arms or my legs. My entire body had turned into a flower. Mom. Dad, somebody help me, I called out. But nobody cared. Oh. So. This music makes me want to cry too, because it's adding like a creepy and sad feeling to it at the same time. No, that's outside, never mind. It's a goal, okay. It's a great reading chair, but it doesn't seem like anyone's using it. The coals are still warm. Nothing useful. Seems like gardening tools. Oh. Eventually, the king found me crying in the garden. I explained what had happened to him. To him? Then he held me, Papyru. He held me with tears in his eyes, saying, there, everything's going to be alright. He was so emotional. But for some reason, I didn't feel anything at all. But you said you were scared earlier. That's an emotion. Fear is an emotion. That counts. You took the key and put it in your phone's keychain. No chocolate. There's some white fur stuck in the- Jesus. I've read this already, but what does it say? I haven't read it already! Did I? So it's an old stovetop. It's a trash can. It's full of crumpled up recipes for butterscotch. It's weird. Okay. I unlocked the chain. The date I came here. What? I soon realized I didn't feel anything about anyone. Oh. My compassion had disappeared. I'm almost about to cry. And believe me, it's not like I was trying. I wasn't trying. I wasted weeks with that stupid king, vainly hoping I would feel something. But it became too much for me. I ran away from home. Eventually, I reached the ruins. Inside, I found her, Papyru. I thought of all people, she could make me feel whole again. She failed. And you turned evil, thinking that was okay, Azriel? We know the the fucking flower's Azriel. Or we can call it Flowey for right now, I don't care. I realized those two were useless, even though they're your parents. I became disappointed. I most people would. I just wanted to love someone. I get it. I think you could have. I just wanted to care about someone. But Papyru, you might not believe this, but I've decided it wasn't worth living anymore. Not in a world without love. Is that a LV reference? Not in a world without you. So, I decided to follow in your footsteps. I would erase myself from existence. What? Suicide? And you know what? I succeeded, but you're still here. What? Oh my god. But as I left the mortal coil, I started to feel apprehensive. If you don't have a soul, what happens when you die, right? Something primal started to burn inside me. No, I thought, I don't want to die. That's an emotion too. Then I woke up, like it was all just a bad dream. I was back at the garden, back at my save point. Oh. This game does make it a little weird though. Cause like, does that mean one kid or Flowey plays God? Like, how are you born with the power to change the world? Do other people have this power? Is, if the person's ability, like determination is greater than another, can they control the world only, or can multiple people do it? Can you only control your lifespan or others, or the whole world? It's weird. I don't get it. Cause I'm wondering if this became a movie or something, how would that work? Interested, I decided to experiment. Again and again, I brought myself to the edge of death. At any point, I could have let this world continue on without me. But as long as I was determined to live, I could go back. Amazing, isn't it, Papyru? I was amazed, too. Weird. At first, I used my powers for good. I became friends with everyone. I solved all their problems flawlessly. Their companionship was amusing. For a while, as time repeated, people proved themselves predictable. What would this person say if I gave them this? What would they do if I said this to them? Once you know the answer, that's it. That's all they are. Oh, just like the pacifist run, that's why people do the genocide to see what would happen if I did this instead. Ooh. Predictable little minx, Toby, you made a great game. It all started. It's funny because I don't feel like this game anymore. I just almost feel like this is real life. It all started because I was curious. Curious what would happen if I killed them. And that's what I'm doing. I feel like such an asshole. I don't like this, I told myself. I don't like it either. Trust me. I'm just doing this because I have to know what happens. Right, same. Haha, what an excuse. I hear you with that disgusting face. You of all people must know how liberating it is to act this way, I guess. At least we're better than those sickos that stand around and watch it happen. I love he's referring to me, the player, probably. Those pathetic people that want to see it, but are too weak to do it themselves. Murder is not an exception. Like, don't do that, guys. He's not giving you a good message. And don't commit suicide, either. Like, that's not the answer to if depression or anything. I bet someone like that's watching right now, aren't they? They broke the fourth wall. God damn it. Or maybe that's part of the game. Who knows? Like, maybe I'm the maybe they're god of their world, but I'm god. Like, they're god of their world to reset, but I'm god of them because I control them. Maybe that's what he's referring to. I don't know. Nowadays, even that's grown tiring, I guess. You understand, Papyru. I've done everything this world has to offer. I read every book, burned every book. I've won every game. I've lost every game. I've appeased everyone. I've killed everyone. Sets of numbers, line of dialogue, I've seen them all. But you, you're different. I never could predict you, Papyru. Jesus. There are things I'm trying to think of to say right now, but it's so, like, burning in my head, it's hard. Jesus, dude. Like, I'm trying to think. If I can think of what I want to say, I will, trust me. When I saw you in the ruins, I didn't recognize. Well, yeah, that's what I wanted to say. I thought it was Frisk. The character I'm playing it is Frisk. Why does he keep calling me Papyru? I remember he did that throughout the past episode and goes, no, you're not Papyru. Papyru's dead. He's long gone. Or whatever I named the character at the time. Am I Papyru now? Or is he blinded by his sight? Like, he doesn't know who I am still. Maybe. I don't know. Or maybe, like, Papyru's possessing Frisk. That could be it. I don't know. When I saw you in the ruins, I didn't recognize you. I thought I could frighten you, then steal your soul. I failed. And when I tried to load my save file, it didn't work. Papyru, your determination. Somehow, it's even greater than mine. Because human determination is always greater than a monster's, I think. I just have one question for you, Papyru. How did you get back to the ruins from here? Wait, does you remember the pacifist room? Wait, I know. She must have taken you when she left. Oh, how did I leave the ruins to get here? And then you decided to give... Burial, rather than... What? Did Papyru die? I'm starting to think Papyru is another person that he thinks I am. He might mistake Frisk for Papyru, because I guess we might look alike or something. So, did Papyru die and he thinks he got resurrected? What? Hanging out in the basement forever. What the fuck? But why then? What made you wake up? Did you hear me calling you? Has Papyru always been genocidal or something? It doesn't matter now. I'm so tired of this, Papyru. I'm tired of all these people. I'm tired of all these places. I'm tired of being a flower. Papyru, there's just one thing left I want to do. Let's finish what we started. Let's free everyone. Then let's let them see what humanity is really like. That, despite it all, this world is still kill or be killed. But I killed everyone. They can't see what humanity's like. Also, I think when he did the pacifist run, you could see Azriel. He was like, I think where you fall at the beginning of the game, saying, hey, I'm just here. I'm going to turn into a flower. I think you can talk to him for a little bit, but I don't think I did that. I think I screwed up. I screwed up a lot in the pacifist run. I'm going to play it again, but on my own time. Then, well, I had... Oh, I think when you play the pacifist run... My friends told me, once you play this, you just screw up the game entirely. I don't know what they mean, but whatever. Been entertaining a few ways to use that power. But seeing you here changed my mind. Papyru, I think if you were around, just living in the surface doesn't seem so bad. God. Oh my god, it's depressing. We don't need to leave to get them this time. The king has 6 of them locked away. I've tried hundreds of ways to get him to show me them, but he just won't. Papyrus, I know he'll do it for you. Oh yeah, why am I telling you all this? Papyrus, I said it before. Even after all this time, you're still the only one that understands me. You won't give me any worthless pity. Right. Creatures like us wouldn't hesitate to kill each other if we got in each other's way. So that's why... Oh, am I giving him a dirty look like... Continue. Pulling out the knife like... Continue. Oh! Ha ha ha! Yeah, keep going, dude. What's this feeling? Oh, it's fear. You're finally feeling something, dude. Why am I shaking? Because it's fear. I'm gonna kill you. Yeah, oh my god. Hey, there are things about back then, right? Oh, no. I'm gonna kill you for everything you've done. Hey, what are you doing? Back off! I've changed my mind about all this. No, you haven't. You just don't want to die. This isn't a good idea anymore. You should go back, Papyrus. This place is fine the way it is. No, it isn't. It's time for you to die. Stop making that creepy face! This isn't funny! You've got a sick sense of humor! Oh, I'm not. I'm gonna kill you, my friend. Where are you? This is weird, creepy music. Oh my god, I think we're gonna fight Sans here. Alright, once he kills me once in this fight, video's over. We've played for almost an hour, maybe 2 hours, who knows. Oh, I hope not 2 hours. Oh, I hope not, because that would be bad. That'd be a lot of editing.
Hey, you've been busy, huh?
So, I've got a question for you.
Do you think even the worst person can change?
I'm not gonna do his voice. I kind of have a sore throat in case you guys couldn't tell.
That everyone can be a good person if they just try. Alright. Well, here's a better question. Do you want to have a bad time? Because if you take another step forward, you are really not going to like what happens next. Well, sorry, old lady. This is why I never make promises. Time to kill him. It's a beautiful day outside. Birds are singing. Flowers are blooming. On days like these, kids like you should be burning in hell. What? Oh god!
Well, there, jeez, that was, crazy. There you have it, guys, the Sans fight within 2 seconds. We will fight him, trust me, that's gonna be an entire video. I don't care how long, if it's an hour or 2 hours, I will kill him, hopefully. I think he's 10 times harder than Undyne was. Lucky me, am I right? Anyway, we're gonna fight him soon. But guys, I think that's it for now, and I think it's time to end this video right where it is. Thank you guys so much for watching. You can check out my channel down below to see the other videos that I've done. Like, favorite, share, subscribe, become a full infected, and do all that fun stuff. And I hope to see you all in the next video. Bye, guys.
What we do here is go back.